What is up, guys? It's Tommy here, and welcome to a brand new Football Talk video. And today's topic is that Ian Eyre is stepping down as Liverpool's CEO at the end of the 2016-2017 season. So basically, his contract runs out on May 2017, so a little more than a year from now. And he will be not renewing his contract. Let me know, what do you think about this? Also, who should Liverpool appoint as their new CEO? And also, should Liverpool change their structure and bring in a director of football as well as a CEO? I think Ian Eyre has a very mixed reputation because of failing to complete the signing of the likes of Willian, Diego Costa, Henrik Mkhitaryan, Konoplyanka, but he still brought in some amazing players like Luis Suarez, Philippe Coutinho, Daniel Sturridge, Roberto Firmino, the latest. So I'm actually very grateful for Ian Eyre, and I think that he did a brilliant job in the financial department, because actually when he took over in 2007 we were in a lot of mess. We were on the verge of bankruptcy, we had a court case with the former American owners, George Gillette and Tom Hicks, and Ian Eyre got us through that, and he actually increased Liverpool's revenue and profits by 85% since that time, because Liverpool weren't doing as well as their club size basically suggested that they should do, and Ian Eyre rectified that. He's a brilliant businessman and he is a lifelong Liverpool fan as well. So I think on the financial department he did a very good job. On the player recruitment department we can't really judge him properly because we don't know the exact details of, for example, when he tried to sign Mkhitaryan, because maybe the purse things were tried, maybe he was just working on a, you know, on the behalf of the owners, and maybe it was the owners who didn't sanction some of those deals. So actually, it might be true that Ian Eyre wasn't at fault when he failed to negotiate and failed to bring through those type of signings. For example, the latest when we tried to sign Alex Teixeira from Shakhtar Donetsk, and Shakhtar asked for 30 million, and basically Ian Eyre could have done the deal. The owner said that the money is there, but Jurgen Klopp said no to that deal, and in the end Alex Teixeira went to China. So I think Ian Eyre deserves a lot of credit for example, bringing in the world-class manager Jurgen Klopp, who is in my opinion in the top 5 best managers in world football. Also, he brought us Luis Suarez and other amazing players, and also he got rid of the former owners. He went through with Liverpool through bankruptcy and got us the current owners, who are, you know, not doing amazingly well, but they are building a new stadium. Well, I mean, they are renovating Anfield and expanding Anfield. So basically we will have an extended stadium with a lot more fans, and also financially Liverpool are doing very well. So I think all in all, Ian Eyre's reign as a CEO has been a very successful one in terms of commercial deal. He has done brilliantly. We got so many new sponsors. One of the best shirt deals with New Balance, and also the new sponsor Standard Chartered. Yeah, that has been one of the biggest deals in world football. So I think financially we are doing very well. But the big question is now, what will happen next? Because I think FSG, the owners, have to nail the next appointment. And there is a huge possibility that we could be closer to the top of the Premier League in the next 3 years than expected. Because at the moment we are very much outsiders, but there are a lot of chaos and a lot of uncertainty at other top clubs. As you can see, Leicester City are top of the Premier League, because Man City, Arsenal, Chelsea, Man United, they are all doing below par. So actually there is a big opportunity and for Liverpool to jump up much higher, maybe next season, if we can get in the right players in the summer, and if we can get in the right CEO in 2017, Liverpool have a massive opportunity to seize this chance, seize this uncertainty at other clubs, and jump maybe a lot higher and a lot closer to the top of the league than we were, you know, realistically hoping for after, you know, the Brendan Rodgers era with Jurgen Klopp and with a proper CEO as good or even better as Ian Ayre. I think we have a big possibility of challenging for the Premier League title in the next 2 or 3 years. Maybe not next season, but who knows? There is so much unpredictability in the Premier League at the moment. I mean, who would have thought that the two main title contenders would be Leicester City and Tottenham, who were just nowhere near title contention before the season even started. And who knows, it can happen next season. And if Liverpool can buy the right players, anything can happen. That's the nature of the beast. That's the nature of the Premier League. So that's why I'm very optimistic for the future, especially because we have a world-class manager, Jurgen Klopp. If we can get Liverpool anywhere near the top four, anywhere near the Europa League final this season, with basically Brendan Rodgers' players, imagine what he can do when he has one or two transfer windows to bring in his own players. And I'm very, very excited for the future. So let me know, what do you think about this news, Ian Ayre resigning? And I just got home from my girlfriend because she became very sick yesterday, so I had to go over her house and take care of her. But I will be back with more career mode videos tomorrow, so stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching, guys. Enjoy watching the Champions League. See you later. Goodbye.